Hey Premiere Pros, it's Paul Murphy here, and today I'm going to show you a quick way to create a scanline effect in Premiere Pro. Okay, so I have some footage here in my timeline that I'd like to add a scanline effect to. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to go up to my graphics and titles menu, and I'm going to choose new layer and rectangle. And that's added a rectangle in my program monitor. It's also added a graphic clip in my timeline. I'm just going to drag this out to the edge of the clip below it. And then I want to make some changes to this rectangle. So I'm going to do that using the Essential Graphics panel. I'm going to go up to Window and then choose Essential Graphics. And there it is over on my right. And the other thing I want to do is I want to have snapping turned on so I can snap to this rectangle. So I'm going to select my program monitor, and then I'm going to go up to my view menu and choose snap in program monitor. And now when I do that, if I go over this anchor point here, I can click and drag this and snap it to the top of the rectangle. Then I'm going to click and drag the rectangle and snap it to the top of my screen, and I'll extend the edges out so that they're the length of the screen. And I might also just drag this down as well. So it's about halfway down my screen. And now what I want to do is I want to make duplicates of this rectangle so I can get a scanline effect. And I'm going to do that with an effect that is replicate. So I'll look up replicate in my effects. I'll click and drag this above my shape. And then I'm going to select it and go over to my effect controls panel. And over here, you can see the count is set to 2. I'm going to turn this all the way up, which is probably not high enough for what I need for a scanline effect, but that's okay. I can go over to my Essential Graphics, and I'm going to right click and choose duplicate. And so now we've got a lot of scan lines going on. I can actually knock this back a bit as well. You can see I've got 16 and then 16 here. I might just turn these ones down a little bit as well, so we don't have so many there. And now we can basically control whatever we want to do with these scan lines. For something like this, probably what I would do is go in and change the fill from this gray color to a black, like this. So we've got some nice dark scan lines there. And I might also change the blend mode on this. So if I select the graphic layer in the timeline, I'm going to go over to my opacity settings, and I'll set the blend mode to maybe something like overlay. So we have some interesting effects with the light and dark there. And probably the only other thing that I would add to this is something like a blur. So if I go in here, I'll grab a Gaussian blur, and I'll drag this to the very top of the layer stack here and just turn the blur up ever so slightly so that the layers are sort of blending with each other. And that has very quickly created an effect like this. Hey, thanks for watching this video. I hope you found it useful. And if you did, please like and subscribe, and maybe check out some of these other videos.